Hi, my name is Kimberly Knowles, and today I'm going to give you some tips for how to use our Explore Their Path blog to help with your major and career explorations. So first of all, to get to it, I recommend, you can get to it from our Explore Your Path portal by clicking on Explore Their Path, which will then take you to kind of this landing page, which gives, a little bit of background about what the portal, what the blog is. And then if you click on the picture, it'll pull up the actual blog. Now the actual address for the blog, if you wanted to get to it directly, is just usfblogs.usfca.edu/explore-their-path. So that's another perhaps easier way to get to it if you wanted to bookmark it in your browser. So when you get there, first of all, we have one pinned post, which I'm actually going to play for you now really quick. It's a video that we filmed with a student in the past. We had an intern who helped us. And it gives a little bit of perspective on why we think kind of using this sort of sister blog to explore other people's stories would be helpful for you in your major and career exploration. So I'm going to go ahead and play that for you now.
When I was applying to USF originally, I was debating between accounting and biology, which are completely different. I chose biology because I took a lot of science classes in high school, and my AP biology teacher was amazing, and she really inspired me to pursue biology as a career. I really do enjoy science, but I realized that I don't want to make a career out of it necessarily. I really wanted to switch my major, but I kind of wanted to push it a little bit more. I didn't want to give up too soon. Actually, earlier this semester, I got a text message from my mom, and she said, "Danielle, if you want to switch your major, go ahead and do it. I support you." And I didn't even talk to her about wanting to switch my major, so even from her viewpoint, she can kind of see I wasn't really happy with being a biology major. So I talked to my college advisor, and I met with the head of the accounting department, and they were both completely supportive. I went to the mandatory accounting society meeting for freshmen and sophomores, and I really felt, I kind of sat down in like the auditorium in McLaren, and I took a step back and I kind of looked around for a second, and I felt like these are my people, I felt like I really belonged there, and I kind of realized you can't fool yourself into thinking you're something that you're not. So I really felt like I was becoming more of who I am as a person. Part of me wishes I just went straight into accounting right when I entered USF, but then I wouldn't be who I am today. I wouldn't be sitting here, first of all, and I wouldn't have the knowledge that I acquired over changing my major. So I feel like everything happens for a reason. It's really scary to change your major because you're changing the course of your life in a way. So you have to have a lot of courage to do it. Whether you're switching from any major to another, it doesn't matter, it's still a big change. I would say talk to your CASA advisor, and I really think YouTube is a great resource because when you hear different stories, it really, you can kind of identify with that sometimes and find yourself in those stories. So I'd say do that, and definitely maybe sit in a couple classes of a major you're considering and just sit there and listen in and see if that's something you're interested in. And just talk to your advisors, talk to the head of the department you're interested in. Just do your research, because you don't want to jump into something you have no idea about.
So hopefully that gives you a little bit of background. Just like Danielle was talking about encouraging you to look on YouTube to view other people's stories, when she made that video, we didn't have the blog. And it somewhat inspired us to kind of create this sort of additional resource where you could look up stories curated from all around the web, from USF's community, with students, faculty, staff, and alumni who were in particular majors and minors, to kind of learn a little bit about them and see if maybe they could be kind of your people or your major tribe. So we really encourage you. You certainly could just jump in and read kind of the whole blog. We're still kind of adding more and more content all the time. And sometimes you don't know by just reading a story, even if it's completely unrelated to majors you're considering, it might cue something in you and you might say, wow, I never thought about that as a minor, or I never thought about that would even be something, that would seem interesting to me. But if you want to kind of hone in and narrow your interests, there's a couple ways you can do that. First, if you're on your mobile, this is sometimes the easiest way to look up the particular majors. So like you could see, okay, what's, history? What are people doing for history? And so that will pull up. There's a variety of different things. Like sometimes we have videos. We had an intern that helped us film some students talking about their majors and minors. Sometimes it's a story that maybe we've curated from somewhere on USF's website or somewhere in the USF news that talks about a faculty member or a student, an alum that's doing something cool that kind of majored in that area. Other times we have profiles, and you can kind of see, let's see if we look up data science. And what I just did there on the right, that's another way you can pull up particular majors, is you could click on the right. It's basically the same thing. But so like this was a student who filled out our actual profile form, and it asked him things about like what was his previous major, what did he like about, you know, what does he like about his major, what does he find challenging, what kind of things has he done outside of class, and just any kind of general advice that he has. Now keep in mind, when we tag a student a post, we actually tag both the majors and minors the person is leaving and the ones they're going to. So just be aware of that. I still think either way it can give you valuable information. Like if you're thinking about a particular program, you know, you should be aware that there's challenges with any major and minor. And there's also things that people find really neat about them. So it's all just to kind of assist with your research. You can also search by keyword. So if you're interested, if you're like, let's say you're in a particular activity, like you're in a choir, and you want to see if there's anything, anybody else that was in a choir, and what are they doing? So you can kind of see, like, here was a student who happened to mention in her extracurriculars that she was in a choir, and so she's actually doing something with music. But it can be different things, like someone, you know, maybe if they're in the Senate, the ASUSF, you know, basically that just pulls from anything that we shared about, you know, shared at least in our text on the blog. Here's an example of a story that was pulled from another profile. And so you can also use that to find different stories that might be of interest. We don't have 100% of the majors and minors represented yet. We've got a lot of them, but we're adding more and more all the time. So you can follow on USF_CASA's Instagram page. We're going to be kind of doing some posts this semester as we add new posts to the blog. So feel free to look on there. You also can subscribe by email to receive updates, you know, as we add more and more content. I think I still need to add an RSS feed, but we'll probably be adding that soon. So if you're an RSS feed kind of person, there should be, I'll probably have a way on the bottom as well for you to do that. And then, like I said, we are still trying to get more of the majors and minors, you know, represented. So as you get further along in your major exploration, we would love for you to share your story with us. If you're a student, a staff, faculty member, alumni, you can click this, share your path with others. And it gives a form that you can fill out. It'll customize it, you know, based on what you put here if you're a student. You can answer our questions, and that'll help us put it up on the blog. Or if you're someone who really likes to kind of just reflect in more of an open-ended way, you can also email us at exploretheirpath@usfca.gmail.com. We also have this information about sharing your path on the portal itself. So if you're viewing this video and you want to share this with some of your students or friends, this is probably the easiest link to pass on. And actually, you can even just do myusf.usfca.edu/share-your-path. It goes to the same place. It gives kind of instructions about sharing your story, because we are always looking for new people to share their paths with us. So if you're just kicking off your exploration, great. But as you get further along, we would love to hear from you in the future. But that's our blog, and you know, we hope you'll enjoy both our original portal, the Explore Your Path portal, and also the blog, our sister site, to guide you with your major and career exploration. All right, take care for now.